Hello! Welcome back, you guys. We are here with our lovely panel for the week. First, we have Sean Davis. Give it up.
please.
And the lovely Ali Demopoulos. And making her final appearance on The Mix this season, Christina Jones. Yes. Only one season left. It's so sad. I mean, one episode, not one season. Anyway, so to get right into it, this man is just doing a great job staying on everyone's minds lately. Charlie Sheen, he's at it again. This time he is starting a stand-up tour around America. And the results have been interesting, to say the least. I don't know if you guys have been following it. First show was a bomb.
Yeah.
It was bad.
I definitely heard about it. I didn't think it was possible for Charlie Sheen, like Sheen, to offend me at all. Like, I figured, you know, I'm not a warlock, I'm not a witch, and I think he knows to stay away from black jokes. So I was just like, you know, he can't really get me. But then I guess after the show, he had, like, just, it bombed it completely, and then he invited a rapper to finish the show. And I was like, really? Like, your career is horrible, but really, we have to put on hip-hop, too? Like, he did it. He got me. He really got me on that one.
Well, the New York Times, I love how they put it. They go, this was the headline, belligerent and boozy. And that's just the audience. Like, I feel like that just encompasses the whole show. It's awesome. And then they described Detroit as a ragged mix of video clips, ear-splitting music, profanity-laced monologues, and clumsy attempts to encourage audience participation. And then it was all in the midst of an orgy of depthless vulgarity. Like, listen to that. Those are harsh words.
Yeah.
I
like how they even use drug terms with that. Profanity laced.
That's true.
Yeah. It's Charlie Sheen. We gotta throw the drug verbs. Get them in there.
See, one thing with Charlie Sheen, though, is that I follow him on Twitter, and he started this Twitter, like, internship. And so I was like, oh, I'm totally gonna apply for that.
Because I want to go places in life.
I want to go high places in life, you know? I want a life to remember. And so I applied for it. You had to apply with 140 characters or less. 140 characters, by the way. It's because it's Twitter world. And so I had to do...
That's a very small amount for any mothers in the audience.
I understand.
It's about a sentence that you get. Right?
So I put, my name's Christina Jones. I have hashtag Tigerblood. And I am hashtag winning. And I actually made it to the second round, which was really exciting, because, you know, I saw it in my email and I was so excited. Looked at the date that it was due, and I clicked it, and it ended up that I had missed the due date by, like, 2 days. I clicked it, and it was like, sorry, you are too late.
Looks like you're going to have to get a real job, Christina.
I know, now I don't have the dream job anymore. I was close. I was this close to making it in life.
Moving on, the royal wedding is coming up, Prince William and Kate Middleton. I personally am not enthralled with the whole thing. I think Prince William's a bit unfortunate looking, to say the least. But there have been a lot of things going on with the online gambling sites, especially Bodog.com. And I've been shocked at what these people are actually investing time and money into betting. There's actually a bet. Will Kate jilt William at the altar? And it's 500-1 that people are saying yes. I'm like, who's gonna jilt him at the altar? He could be like a drunk hobo, and if he's the prince and has that money, like, I'm not going anywhere. I'm hanging in, you know?
I'm amazed that there's betting. I just was amazed that there's officialroyalwedding2011.org. Like, not .com, .org. That's what I was amazed at, but there's online betting. That takes it to a whole new level.
Yeah.
Crazy.
Yeah. One of my things is I actually thought Prince William was fairly attractive in his younger days before he actually got serious with Kate. And then
unattractive.
Then once he got serious, he started losing all his hair. Like, he just went, like, straight up president on the second term, bald. And so that's one thing that I feel like Kate, like, he just has to now because she's already ruined his looks. Like, he's stuck with her.
We're all praying for him. We really are. I just really hope he makes it through, you know? I'm over it. I don't want to talk about it. I didn't know who he was in the beginning. I still don't want to know who he is now. Like, let's just have the wedding.
That's a selling point. I don't know who the prince is, so whatever.
It's not my country.
Hey, you need to know he has a Pez dispenser. There's a Kate and Prince Pez dispenser out there.
Wow.
Collector's item.
God.
eBay.
It's kind of disgusting. We also had the NCAA championship game this week. You guys watch? Yeah. Ugly game. It was a really ugly game, wasn't it? In fact, Butler had an 18.8 shooting percentage, which made it one of the worst shooting percentages in NCAA title game history, which I must say the record was beaten after the last time was 1941 when WSU made the lowest shooting percentage.
Yeah.
any reason to say Go Cougs, right?
Yeah, Go Cougs.
I love that that's our national mention in the NCAA championship. Wow, we haven't seen such a poor game in history since, 1941 when the Cougars played. My God. Horrible. It's like, proud to be a Cougar. It's great.
And the UConn, man, I'm just, they're probably the first group probably to actually win a championship and none of them will make it to the NBA. Like,
right.
It's just going to be so horrible.
Kemba Walker.
Not a championship game like that. If you can't handle the championship game in pressure, then the NBA on J.J. Redick, Morrison, I forget his first name. Adam Morrison, yeah. Yes.
Gonzaga.
So when I'm looking at his picture, the guy on the right, the far left, or far right, looks kind of confused that they actually won the game.
He's like, wait, is this my team?
Is this real? Is this real life? Like, we only scored like 20 points.
You check the stats. Are you sure we won?
I know. It was a pretty painful game overall. Moving on to very different news. Snooki from Jersey Shore. Don't know if you guys are followers of Snooki, but she just got paid $32,000 by Rutgers University to come speak and be like a motivational speaker. I'm not sure what part of Snooki's life you highlight to motivate college kids. But $32,000, and a spokesperson from Rutgers said that, well, the students really wanted it and we had the funds available. It's like, you had the funds available, you had $32,000, kick some of that to WSU so we get better entertainment than Colby Calais on Mom's Weekend. Really? Really?
Students wanting her to speak, like, we're college educated. I would hope you want to be inspired by someone other than Snooki. That
I know.
Blows my mind. Blows up.
I feel like take me back a few years in IQ. Like,
That's what America's coming to.
I know.
What's going on?
That's the smart part about it. It's just because, like, I mean, who better to motivate you to stay in school and graduate than Snooki?
You know what? That's a good call.
It would be the reverse effect. And then on the same note, Bristol Palin was just paid $262,000 to be the ambassador for the Candies Foundation, which promotes abstinence, because she got knocked up when she was 20, and
I don't think she was like
16. Younger than that.
Younger, okay.
It was younger.
Hopefully, if you're advocating for teen pregnancy.
That's right. Yeah. So she now she's getting paid hundreds of thousands of dollars to speak out on abstinence. Which it's like, wait, how did that work? You know what I mean? It's like you have the kid and now you get paid to speak on abstinence. I feel bad for the kid.
Well, and I feel like she's proof that abstinence education doesn't work. And I won't get out any further than that because that can get heavy. But like, come on, we're college kids. That stuff isn't happening.
Right.
But the thing is that like, there's a study, Candies Foundation, and granted the foundation who she's a spokesperson of did the study, but that they did a study of 1,000 teens surveyed, compared Palin's PSAs to other teen pregnancy ads, and what happened was, Candies Foundation says that more than twice as many teens said that the PSA that Palin was in got their attention, twice as many, three times as many said it was more powerful, and then more than twice as many said it was memorable. So of course it's gonna be memorable. We know that already.
Right.
Bristol's memorable.
Yeah.
But that blows my mind. I wonder if they're tweaking those a bit, I feel like. Candies, I don't know.
I don't know. I'm just flabbergasted that you get that much money to get knocked up in high school. It's like, who was there to tell me that? I would have been popping out kids left and right if I was gonna get $262,000 from Candies. My God.
See, my thing is that, Bristol Palin talking about teen abstinence is like Charlie Sheen speaking for the DARE program in, elementary school. It's just not supposed to happen.
It doesn't work. On to Dancing with the Stars. Kirstie Alley is on this season. Yeah. Need I say more, right? She just had a very, very tragic fall in one of her dance routines. And I actually didn't need to watch the episode to know that she fell. I actually felt my apartment shake in Pullman when she fell. And I was like, Kirstie Alley must have just dropped down. So, and I love it. The song her and her partner are dancing to was Somewhere Over the Rainbow. And it's like, Somewhere Over the Rainbow, Kirstie Alley is skinny and graceful, but unfortunately on this side of the rainbow, she's still breaking chairs. What did you guys think of it?
Well, with Kirstie Alley, she said she wants to weigh 128 pounds by the end of the show. Now, I don't feel like it's realistic to lose over 300 pounds in a 3-month period. as well as she has her own weight loss brand that she's had since 2008. Now, I feel like it's a very unsuccessful weight loss brand to have if you have stayed the exact same weight and maintained your weight for 3 years.
Can you imagine being the person who says, no, you're too fat for this weight loss program, you're next.
You're done.
That
would
be
she started
hard.
Her own.
You,
like,
yeah,
she,
you shouldn't start that in the first place.
She was probably on Jenny Craig and like, okay, you have to have portion control. She's like, oh, no, 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 I have my own diet now. Like, I'm allowed to eat this and this and this.
Yeah.
And it will somehow work. It will just work.
It will work somehow. And that's supposedly her partner in real life now?
Yeah, they're now
dating.
Really? I saw the kiss itself. They were kissing each other.
On Twitter, right?
No.
Yeah, on Twitter, right?
It wasn't on Twitter. It was in a magazine, you know. Stepping it up. Stepping up my research.
Well, I'm sure he has to apologize a lot for all the pain that he was showing in the picture. I mean, I just feel bad for him. Like, if she was to fall on me, I'd tap out in 3 seconds. Like, immediately.
Yeah. I know. He's quoted as saying that my thigh just gave out during the dance. That was the problem. My thigh just gave out. I was like, I think
weird.
There was the weight of a sumo wrestler currently right on that thigh when it just gave out. But that would probably hurt the relationship for him to say that. So lastly, Victoria's Secret model has been recently reported. Yeah, check out this middle one. Isn't that terrifying? Anyway, she might lose her contract with Victoria's Secret for being too skinny and having lost too much weight, which she attributes, she said, to too much extensive traveling. That's why she's lost so much weight, is the extensive traveling. I'm like, okay, is it just me? Because when I do extensive traveling, it's followed by extensive weight gain from the extensive trips to McDonald's.
Yep.
You know what I mean? It's just like, that doesn't happen. What is she doing on these travel trips?
Well, and I feel like, I don't know, first of all, there's a quote here, Victoria's Secret represents all women, no matter what shape and size, and that's from a model, obviously, I'm sure she's paid to say that. You've got to be kidding me. Those women are not voluptuous. They might be curvy and like, genetically blessed because they're like that and like that.
Well, there's no way. Curves count as like bones jutting out. At
exactly.
I mean, they did have Tyra Banks.
Yeah, that's but she's true. Not even like crazy voluptuous. I still think she like is our American ideal of beauty as far as thin and then big breasts and stuff. That's crazy.
See, my thing with this is that maybe if Kirstie Alley and the Victoria's Secret model switched diet plans, Kirstie Alley would actually lose the weight, and then the model can go on the Kirstie Alley diet plan, and then it would be all good because she'd be the right weight for Victoria's Secret.
Oh, I like it. I'm behind it. So that has been our panel for the week. Thank you, guys. And when we come back from the break, we're going to have Riley Michaelbust. Correct? Did I say it right this time?
Yes,
I said Michaelbust. I'm so sorry, Riley. You're in the crowd. We will have our new ASWCU president when we come back for an interview, so stay tuned. I saw it. It'd be like, good idea.